ladies and gentlemen, to our second act of the afternoon. We have the fantastic Shambles Big Band. They were like ninjas getting themselves set up so quickly. We're very impressed. So enjoy the rest of your afternoon. Shambles Big Band.
She said,
yeah.
And then she said, I always cut mine in butter.
Hello.
Oh, good. Oh. Hey.
Oh.
Yes, that was a bit tense, wasn't it? I mean, talking of such things, I was watching this football match and it was getting really tense, and then just before the end, they all started karate chopping each other. I said to the bloke next to me, what the hell's going on? He says, it's ninjury time. Oh, come on. It might have been rubbish, but it was quick. Yeah. Right, this is the Shambles Big Band. Not much to look at, I know. But you'd probably rather do that than listen to us. This is our first concert in 19 months, so we've had one rehearsal. So we're sort of making it up as we go. So when it's rubbish, don't shout at us. And we've got some lovely people. Our first trumpet player shoved off, pathetic excuse, is on honeymoon. I mean, you'd have thought, you know, they've got planes, he could have come back. But he didn't. So we've got a former lead trumpet of the band has returned to us in the shape of Graham Bagley. Thank you, Graham. We've got a new member of the band, amazing trumpet player, Paul Mayle. And we've got a poor young lady in the audience who used to play for us. Haven't seen her for ages, she's been away at university. So I said, get your trumpet, dear. So in a while, somebody else will slide in and I shall embarrass her thoroughly when her trumpet arrives from Toddington. Right, that was called Shambolic. That was written by Chris, our second trumpet player and all-round composer. And we are now going to play Fly Me to the Moon. I say that because I changed the order and I just hope everybody was listening. So hopefully nobody is frantically scrabbling for music behind me now and they were listening when I changed the order. Say yes, Paul.
Yes, Paul.
Good. Fly Me to the Moon.
Yes, Paul. Looks like getting involved.
The tune after this. One, two, three, four. On tenor sax, that's Rebecca. It's okay to give them a round of applause in the middle of a piece. That's fine. That's what you can do in jazz concerts. Unless it's rubbish, of course, in which case don't bother. We are now going to play a special piece of music. We're now going to recover my music from the other side of the bandstand because it's just blown off. And this piece of music is a Chinese piece and it's called Tuning.
Tune, please.
Out. Can I be flat for the trumpets, please? Be flat for the trumpets, please. Okay, sorry about that. It's you see, the saxes are out in sunshine, so their instruments are getting flatter and flatter and flatter as they warm up, and the brass is in the shade, so they're not going wrong. So we ended up a little bit bleh. Okay, this number's from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. I knew I'd get there in the end. Arranged by Sammy Nestico, it is called The Candyman. Now we got a Henry Mancini number, Moon River, from the film Breakfast at Tiffany's. I'm a bit of an innocent. I'd seen Breakfast at Tiffany's a few times, and I never quite tweaked what her job was. And if there's any children in the audience, ask your parents. I'm not telling you. So this one's called Moon River. Thank you. Thank you. In that number you heard from Louise on trombone, Carolyn on trombone, and Chris on trumpet. Now this next number should have special relevance to all the married men in the audience. It's called Doghouse. I mean, it's not easy being a married man, is it? My wife wanted me to go to a fancy dress party as a flamingo. I had to put my foot down. I tell you, I replaced our bed with a trampoline. Why fit the roof? She started one of these tropical fruit diets. It's enough to make a man go crazy. But our wedding was very emotional. Even the cake was in tears. Right. Is that enough?
Yeah.
Hopefully. All right, good. It's given Katie enough time. Big round of applause for Katie, who's going to be very embarrassed now. Poor Katie, 3 years away at uni, just came to listen to us. I said, I'm a trumpet down. And I think we also need a round of applause for Katie's dad, who's just driven a trumpet all the way here from Toddington. Well done, Katie's dad. Thank you, Les. Not only is Katie standing in for us, but she's rejoined the band. I'm a quick mover. Now, neither did I find out she was here. I persuaded her to play this afternoon and to rejoin the band. So I'm feeling chuffed with myself. Right, here comes Doghouse.
Thank you.
On saxes, we had Rebecca and Jonathan.
If you try and beat the chords,
that. So while we put Katie's trumpet back together, which hasn't been played since she left university 3 years ago, we've done rather well on university since we broke up. We've got Charlotte Soft going off to Trinity College of Music. Well done, Charlotte. Katie's just graduated with something very posh and arty. Louise is reading history at Oxford. Anybody else shoved off to university? I've retired, so I don't care. Right, this next number is called Catwalk, and I can honestly say I don't know the first thing about it. I don't know who played it. I only know who wrote it because it says so at the top. I've never heard another band play it. But I like it, so I'm playing it anyway.
Thank you.
We're going a bit Latin American, which from the way I'm feeling in this heat at the moment is about right. This is the girl from Ipanema. Interesting one, this one. It was written by Antonio Carlos Jobim. Jobim. And the story goes that they finished writing it with his mate Vincas de Mora, another guy, and they couldn't. They just wanted to do a demo track. So Antonio Carlos's job girlfriend just happened to be there. So they said, "Look, just sing these words, so we can do a demo track." And that's the track that became famous. So we are now going to completely destroy that reputation in the space of 2.5 minutes. And my smart-ass son has just told me it's the second most recorded song of the 20th century. Take that home, tell people at dinner parties, and you won't be invited anymore. So another one. This one is definitely dedicated to my lovely lady wife, who is in the audience today. And it means I shall be sleeping in the spare room, because this one's called All Right, OK, You Win. One, two, three, four. Ben Bagley on trumpet. Now we're getting about as posh as we get, because this one's from an opera. And we don't play much opera music, I'll give you that. But this one is from the opera Porgy and Bess by George Gershwin. Probably the most successful composer to combine classical and jazz harmonies and rhythms. And this one's called Summertime, and it's a bit mean and moody. Our last number before the break is called Perdido. This is going to come as a slight shock to the band, because I've just changed the order and this is the first time they've heard of it. So they're probably scrabbling around like nutters. Are they scrabbling around like nutters behind me? Yeah, that's good. That's good. I'll give them a moment. Let me see. What jokes haven't I told yet? Literary jokes. I found a lion at the back of my wardrobe. I said, "What are you doing there?" He said, "Minding your business." Last night, I dreamt that I wrote Lord of the Rings. I was Tolkien in my sleep.
Oh, that's why he's a conductor, not a comedian.
You see, that the organisers sat here insulting me. And Jackie, it's just... Anyone would think my jokes were rubbish, honestly.
Yeah.
Welcome back, everybody. This is the second set and final act of our weekend. So it's back to Shambles.
Microphone stand's gone all wonky since Jackie used it. I don't know what she's up to. Right, hopefully you recognise that one as the Pink Panther theme. The most famous animal to come from up north, or to be too precise, he came from Durham. So you've all heard it, he goes Durham, 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 Durham. All right, pace yourselves. Having a go, Duke Ellington, one of the most successful and certainly one of the most long-lived of the great band leaders. And this one's a slow, bluesy number. It's a very... this is not one of my attempts at the jokes. It is a dark blue number because it's called Mood Indigo, and that's what the title was meant to convey that it's a very bluesy one, so feel free to be miserable.
Don't play the instruments. That would be awful. How are we doing? Now, you may be aware that vinyl records have been making a comeback. And one of the most recent releases on vinyl is Great Wasp Songs of the World. Well, up in Cambridge University is the world's leading expert on wasp songs, so he thought, I've got to get me a copy of that. So he gets himself down to the record store, buys it, puts it on, listens to the first track and he thinks, I don't recognise that. And he plays the second track and he says, I don't recognise that either. And so on and so forth. He goes back to the shop. He says, look, I am the world's leading expert on wasp songs and I don't recognise any of these. And the bloke in the shop said, I think I see the problem. You've been playing the B-side. Oh, come on, you didn't pay to get in. What do you expect? Right, April in Paris.
You go to the vinyl shop in Luton, the little town.
I'll try and get the
jokes
answers.
Jokes on that.
They're not good,
the jokes.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
Have you had a chance to look around the museum yet? Got some fantastic windows. I met the man who designed the window frame. What a ledge. Now, this next number's called Georgia on My Mind. It's a slowie, originally written by Hoagie Carmichael to describe a girl named Georgia. It was subsequently adopted by the US state of Georgia as the state tune. Another fact you can bore people with.
Okay. So it starts slow and then it picks up. That's the first four. Don't play that. Yes,
thank you.
we're back to Duke Ellington now, and it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Unless, of course, you haven't yet given to the charity with the lady, in which case it don't mean a thing if you ain't got that tin. So make sure that you pop something in her tin. That'll take up some time. Play slower, guys. You lot, I'm worn out.
Excellent, excellent.
Drove past a field the other day and the horse there was drinking wine. Turns out it was Chardonnay. We call our horse Treacle because he's got golden stirrups. I was riding a horse in the race the other day, I was doing really well until the end when suddenly I was hit by a sandwich, then some grapes, then a bottle of wine. Finished last, the trainer said, what happened? I said, I was hampered in the last furlong. See? Three horse jokes on the trot. Oh, four. Hey. One woman's got a head in her hands there. It's that bad, is it? Yeah. Okay. We're known for our subtlety and quiet demeanour and approach to things, and this isn't it.
Thank you.
Nice little dance number. Now, this one's called Tangerine. Oh, I think someone might be taking the pit. Why did the Mexican push his wife off the cliff? Tequila, which is what we're playing next. This is one with audience participation, the sort of thing you hate, I know. You just have to shout tequila at the right time. It doesn't matter if you don't know the right time, just shout tequila whenever you like and the rest of us will laugh at you. See, they did laugh, didn't they?
Thank you.
Right, we now come to our last number of the afternoon, unless we're forced. And this one's another Miller number, and it's called Tuxedo Junction. Have you noticed how, if you name something after a place in America, it sounds sort of sexy and cool? And if you do it after things in this country, you know, Clapham Junction ain't going to work, is it? Imagine Clapham Junction, or another Miller number, I left a girl in Kalamazoo, I left a girl in Wigan. Somehow it doesn't have the same ring to it, but we're going to let our trombones loose in this one, and it's called Tuxedo Junction. All right, if you absolutely insist, and you do, not that you were prompted at all, another Miller one called In the Mud. Oh, sorry, In the Mood.
Try and play this one right.
Without spelling damage.
Yeah, without the Shambles 15.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four.